Hey, my name's Dan, and this video is an introduction to variables in Framer. We're going to talk about how you can use variables to supercharge your components. So let's just jump in. We've touched on variables in our introduction to components video, but if you missed that, variables are the way we pass properties to components. So if we want our blog post components here to have different titles, descriptions, images, etc., we need to set up variables for those things. The way we do that is to go into the master component, select the title, and next to content, press this little plus button, and we're going to select plain text for now. Give it a name, I'm going to change this to text area, and click away. Now when we go back to our main page, we can change the title. In principle, this is what variables do, allow us to pass information down into our components. But there's a lot more to them than just passing text down. Variables have different types, and we can see that if we go into our component and click on the variables button in the toolbar. Here we can see the title variable we have set up, but if we click this plus button, we can see the different types of variables we have access to. We have plain text, formatted text, link, image, color, toggle, option, number, event, and date. These types are important because each of the fields we want to control has a corresponding type. For instance, our title is a text element, so it can't accept an image, but it can accept plain text or formatted text, or even dates and numbers. So let's go ahead and link up all of the fields in our blog post component. First up, let's add a variable for our description. Let's click on the plus next to content, create variable, and this time we're going to want to use formatted text. Now, a formatted text variable lets you format the text that you pass to this component. That also means that we can set different text styles on this element if we want to. So let's name this description, and I'm going to leave the default style as paragraph. Now, if we head back to our main component, we can see that we can edit the text content of our description, but we can also format it. So I can bold things, I can make things italic. I can also add a link. So I can add a link to this element here. Now, if we preview that, you can see it doesn't look clickable, but there's a link here. To add a link style, we need to go back to our component. Select our description text. This little section allows us to pass in text styles for each of the text types. Now if I go back and preview that, we can see that it looks like a link. Formatted text fields also allow you to change the type of text you pass into them. So we could set this to be an H3 if we wanted. Now that doesn't really make sense for our use case, but it works well for components that need to have different types of text content. We can also use variables as a way to switch between variants of nested components, like our author component here. All we need to do is click on the plus next to variant, create variable, and call it author. And now on our main page, we can switch between variants of that. I'm going to go ahead and do the same for this tag component. But what if we sometimes have a blog post that doesn't have an author? Well, we can set up a variable for that too. All we need to do is add a Boolean variable next to visible. So we're going to say create variable, and we're going to call it has author. Now on our main page, we can just toggle the visibility of that author on and off. One thing to understand about variables is that they are scoped to their particular component. So if we dive into this tag component and click on the variables button, we can see that none of the variables from our blog post component are usable here. If we add a variable for the background color, we can see that it appears here, but it won't appear in our blog post component. All right, so next up, we're going to add a variable for our image. Click on fill, create a variable and give it an image type. We're going to call that cover. And now when we go back to our main page, we can pass in a new unsplash image to our component. So far, this is all pretty simple, so we're going to do something a little bit more advanced. Let's hook up this date text. Now you notice that because this is a text element, when we try add a variable, it only gives us plain or formatted text options. But that would mean we need to manually enter in the date each time, and that kind of sucks. Luckily, Framer has a date variable just for this use case. So let's go ahead and set one of those up. Click on variables up here. We're going to create a new one, and we're going to give it date type. I'm going to call it published at. I'm going to set the date to today. Now if we select our date, we can set the variable to published at, and we're going to select format date. Now you can see we have a bunch of options for the way the date should be formatted. We have short, medium, long, and full. I'm going to go with medium, and I'm also going to add a transform, and I'm going to add a prefix transform. Basically, this allows us to put a little piece of text before the date. So let's write published, making sure to include the space at the end. And now if we go back to our main component, when we select the date, we get a nice little date picker over here, which is much nicer. The last thing we're going to do here is add a link to these components so that they can navigate to their respective blog posts. So if we go in and select the container, we can add a link, and we can add a variable for that link. And now if we go back, we can set the URL for these posts. I only have a dummy page set up, so that I'll have to do for now. So that's pretty much it for the basics of variables. There is actually a lot more ground to cover here, which I go through in my advanced course. You can find the link for that in the description of this video. If you want some more beginner Framer videos, I have a bunch more of those that explain components, layout, and transitions, so check those out. Anyway, catch you next time.